I'm a huge watcher of documentaries, and Netflix has a really controversial documentary coming up called American Circumcision. And I started thinking about it. Why is this so controversial? Because circumcision itself, and I know it's a sensitive topic, and bringing it up here on the show is interesting for me because in this version of For Your Health, this completely fits in. So joining us now, he's in our virtual green room, Anthony Losquadro, founder of Intaction. You can go to intaction.org and find out more about that. He's a circumcision expert. Anthony, thanks so much for popping on.
Hey, Kate. Thanks for having me on the show.
So I'm going to start off with this. Why is it so controversial? And maybe I'm answering my own question. Because, I mean, this is a health segment. We should be able to talk openly about health concerns and how some people feel and how some other people feel. But for some reason, it really is something that's kind of off the table, isn't it?
It is, and that's a great question. You know, it's controversial, really, in America, but the rest of the world, it's controversial for the reverse reasons, because they don't practice circumcision there for the most part. So what's going on in America? It's controversial because Americans have been told for decades this circumcision, cutting off part of the male's body, is so important to do. And now they're starting to get information that maybe they've been misled, and it's natural for people to put the defenses up and to try to protect their ego and their decision making, and say I don't want to discuss this. I was told to do it. It's a health issue. We did it, or I had it done to myself, and that's the way it is. So you know, when somebody brings along new information, that can stir up a controversy.
Yeah, and so, you know, here's the thing. There is no choice in this if people just do it and it's automatic and we assume that this is the right thing to do, because it's routinely done on infants. It just happens, which is, in a different way, crazy. There's no, you don't really have control over it. So I guess that's the question to answer. First of all, what is it?
Well, exactly. I mean, like you said, a baby has no control over it. The individual has no control because he can't consent to it. And it's almost, you know, it's the same circumstances as what's done to little girls in other parts of the world where they do female genital mutilation. And the advocates that are against that, they would dispute that. But it, essentially, it's the same thing whether you're doing it to a boy or a girl. And you know, That's
what it is. Yeah, it's another aspect. So here's the question. Is it, for people listening, you know, we're talking about, and especially because now it'll be raised even more with this Netflix documentary, American Circumcision, is it harmful?
You know, it is harmful for two reasons when it's done to baby boys. First of all, there's the pain and the trauma, okay? You have to realize doctors can't use anesthesia on a baby. So the baby's getting the full brunt of this procedure that takes as long as 15 minutes. People like to imagine, oh, it's just a snip. It happens really quick. This is a 15-minute-plus procedure in which the foreskin is crushed in a clamp-like device in order to get hemostasis or to stop the bleeding. It's just a fancy term. And it's like getting your finger caught in a car door and slamming it shut, except we're going to keep the car door slammed shut until the bleeding stops. That's what circumcision is about. So it's painful. This, you know, people, the second myth is that people think, well, babies can't remember it, so no harm, no foul. And, you know, just because a baby or an individual or a child can't remember something, that doesn't mean it doesn't affect him. Okay, the pain and trauma done to babies during this procedure has been associated with changes in the brain, in particular the hippocampus, which is the area that controls memory, emotion, and other functions that are crucial for development. You know, when a baby is born, its brain is like a blank slate and is making millions of neural connections from the moment that it's born, and so it can, you know, it's critical for its survival going forward, so it knows how to interact with its environment. And the first thing that it's subjected to is this intense, incredible pain and trauma, and it has all the elements of PTSD. The brain and the adrenal glands dump cortisol into the body, which is a stress hormone. We're doing all this pain and trauma to a baby for no reason, because you know over 22 medical associations around the world specifically say we do not recommend infant circumcision.
Yeah, there you go. So there are organizations saying that. How many, and I know statistically it's probably hard to even come up with this, but how many circumcisions do you figure that are done? Because I think it's got to be a high number.
Well, you know, to answer your question directly, it's probably in the United States, it's probably about 1 million done every year.
Wow.
The rates in, as of 2012, which is the last hard data we have from CDC, was about a 56% circumcision rate. Those rates are dropping, so now we're into 2019. So we think we're approaching the 50-50 mark, because more and more people are realizing that we're not doing this to our son. This is just crazy. But so we're at about 50-50. And you have to realize other parts of the world, like Europe, It's like under 5%. Nobody does this. When we talk to a European, they say, you know, we have this problem in America where they're obsessed with circumcision. They're so taken back, and they can't believe what we do to our children.
Yeah, there you go. We're speaking with Anthony Losquadro. He's the founder of Intaction here on For Your Health. So tell us about what you do. What does Intaction do?
Well, you know, Intaction is an organization I started because I felt that babies needed a voice in this, and Americans were sorely lacking in good information on it. So what Intaction does is our main thing is we run public events. We have mobile units where we go out and our advocates distribute literature, engage people in conversation, and talk to them about this issue. We talk about things, you know, it's an unusual job, but, you know, if we don't do it, who's going to do it? And we talk about, you know, the four powers of foreskin, which is the benefits foreskin provides, which is pleasure, protection, lubrication, and connection. Nature put it on our body for a very good reason. It's in our DNA. We're supposed to have it.
Yeah, and you talk about this. I mean, you mentioned this with the babies. You assume, oh, no big deal. But it makes me wonder, how did this start? Where's the history of this?
Well, it's a really bizarre history in America. You know, it wasn't common in America up until around the 1890s or so. And a movement started where it was believed masturbation was the cause of many medical illnesses and psychological harm. So they started on a campaign to try to prevent this, and you have people, notables like Dr. Kellogg, who was the inventor of Kellogg's cornflakes. He was a celebrity doctor of his day, and he was one of the advocates along with others like John Lewis Sayer, who became president of the American Medical Association, and they started this campaign in America to start circumcising babies. First, they tried to get men to be circumcised, but that was too difficult of a sell. If you're an intact male, someone says, well, we're going to cut off your foreskin. You're gonna have.
Yeah,
World
you're
War
not III. Doing it. Yeah, yeah, exactly. I agree.
III. And they didn't have World War III yet. So, So they said, "Well, all right, that's not selling. Let's convince the parents to do it to their children," and that took off. And under the guise of masturbation, and then they said, "Well, it prevented polio and typhus and all these other types of diseases," which, you know, the reasons they dreamed up were a legend. And it became a business after that. And they started circumcising. As more and more babies became born in hospitals as opposed to home, doctors just started doing it automatically. Parents didn't even have a choice in the matter. And then it became a business, and it became a cultural norm. And then after a while, parents expected it to be. It became, you know, a symbol that your baby was born in a hospital and you were upper class. And that's how it became entrenched in America. And we're really unique from the rest of the world.
Yeah.
Where this didn't happen.
Well, you said it. There's the word. You were considered upper class. So it's like keeping up with the Joneses. That's a weird analogy, but it's true. So if they're doing it, they're doing it, they're doing it. That's what happens. You become like sheep in whatever we're talking about. And then you don't question enough. So that's what's so interesting. We question, especially because some of the horrible things we've seen about genital mutilation for females, but we really haven't questioned very much about men, have we?
You know, we haven't, but, you know, times are changing. People are talking about it.
Yeah.
And, you know, and not only that, they're realizing that, you know, we criticize other cultures for cutting girls, but then those other cultures turn around and say, you're a hypocrite because you're doing it to your sons.
Exactly. It's crazy. All right, check out Intaction. intaction.org. That's the best place to find out more information about it. Anthony, thanks so much for spending time with us here on the show.
Kate, thanks for giving me this opportunity to help try to enlighten Americans on this issue.
Yeah, absolutely. Think about it, America. Check it out, and thanks so much for listening to us.